Any lectures about buffer regions and when they're going to occur in titration diagrams. First of all, let's define what a buffer is. A buffer is a solution of a weak acid and its conjugate base, and this solution will resist changes in pH upon addition of a strong acid or a strong base. The weak acid I'm going to be talking about will be acetic acid, which I'm going to abbreviate AH, and its conjugate base is A minus. The conjugate base is found by taking H plus off the conjugate acid. What we're left with is this, the A minus. Now, on a titration curve, a buffer region is easy to see because it's a flat area, and it's flat because what's happening is we've got a mixture of AH and A minus at this point, and when the OH minus is added to this mixture, we're getting just a very small rise in pH. In other words, what's happening is this solution of AH and A minus is resisting a change in pH as the strong base OH minus gets added to the buffer solution. It's only after the AH gets eaten up by the OH minus that we see a huge rise in pH after the buffer loses its effect. So this plateau region is what I'm calling the buffer region in the titration curve. Well, let's talk about when they're going to occur and when they're not going to occur. Well, if you start off with a solution of acetic acid, AH, let's say we start off with six of them over here. If I add two OH minuses or two moles of OH minus, what's going to happen is this. The acetic acid reacts with the sodium hydroxide to form A minus. So what we're going to be left with after we've added two OH minuses is we'll have four AHs, that's four of the original six, and then two of the AHs will turn into A minuses. Remember that the sodium hydroxide gets destroyed by the acetic acid, by the AH. So the AH reacts with the OH minus to form A minus. So what we have at this point here is a mixture of AH and A minus. That is a mixture of a weak acid and its conjugate base. So we're going to see a buffer formed here along the titration curve. As we add sodium hydroxide, you'll notice that the pH doesn't go up very much, and that's because we're adding sodium hydroxide to this buffer solution and it's resisting the change in pH. After the OH minus has eaten up all the AH, it's only then that we get this large rise in pH to the equivalence point and beyond. Right, so that's a case where we will see a buffer region. Now here's an instance where we won't see a buffer region. What we're going to see here is we've got sodium hydroxide, we're starting off with that, and we're adding a weak acid to that, and that's going to be our AH. So at the very beginning, all we've got is, let's say, six OH minuses. If we add two AHs to those six OH minuses, the two AHs will react with the two OH minuses to form two A minuses. So after we've added two AHs, what we've got is four OH minuses and two A minuses. This does not constitute a buffer solution. This is a solution of a strong acid and a weak conjugate base. So we never get to see the same buffer region as we saw over here. The kind of situations where you will see buffers are when you add a strong base to a weak acid, and you will not see a buffer region if you add a weak acid to a strong base. Okay, there's another situation in which buffering can occur, and that's when we're taking a weak base and we're titrating with a strong acid. So let's say we've got a weak base, and this would be ammonia or ammonium hydroxide as I've got written here. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a strong acid to that. Now initially, let's say we start off with 6 moles of this. Each mole will react with HCl and form 1 mole of the conjugate acid of this weak base. So what we're going to have is if we have two HCls reacting with two of these Bs, we're going to end up with two BHs. So what we'd be left with at this point would be 4 Bs and 2 BHs. This is a mixture of a weak base and its conjugate acid. So we are getting a buffering situation going on here. So as we add the HCl, we don't get a huge drop in pH. It's kind of flat because we're adding HCl to a buffer solution, a mixture of a weak base and its conjugate acid. If we take the reverse case where we're going to titrate a strong acid with a weak base, we're going to start off with 6 moles of strong acid, 6 H pluses here. And as we add the NH3, let's say we add 2 of them, then 2 of the bases will react with 2 of the acids and form 2 BHs. So what we would be left with here at this point would be 4 moles of strong acid and 2 moles of a weak conjugate acid. This is not a buffer solution, so no buffering is going to occur here. In summary, what we can say is that when a weak base is titrated with a strong acid, we will get buffering. When a strong acid is titrated with a weak base, we will not get buffering. Also note that when strong acids and strong bases are titrated with each other, no buffering occurs because no possibility for weak acids or weak bases exists in those situations.